Tāna whālawa, welcome back. Well, as we saw earlier, Mangere MP, Honourable Aupito William Seor, gave his valedictory speech at Parliament this week, bringing to an end a career in the House that spans nearly 16 years. So what's in store for him now, and how will his former colleagues fare in the coming election? Joining us this morning for our Talanoa is Aupito William Seor. Thank you very much for joining us on the show.
Rafte Marama, thanks for having me.
First of all, I just want to talk about your valedictory speech, your last speech in Parliament on Tuesday. Wow, what an amazing speech. And just to see you standing there in your traditional Samoan attire.
Well, it was my last speech.
Go out with a bang.
I did ask the Speaker about a couple of months ago.
You warned him.
I said, how do you feel about my delivering my last speech in my traditional attire? He says, that should be all right. Shouldn't be a problem. I says, I need to say that my traditional attire means I won't be wearing a shirt. and he smiled. But I thought it was important for me from all sides. When I first came in 2008, I remember the Speaker then, the Right Honourable Margaret Wilson, allowed me to be able to be sworn in Samoan. And then when National came in, those buggers challenged me.
Oh, wait.
And so, you know, I says, no, I'm a Samoan that lives in New Zealand. I want to be sworn in my language. I'm bilingual. You guys need to understand that. In the end, they allowed, but that was because Trevor Mallard, who was the whip at the time, you know, championed me. And then, you know, I do the same. And then in 2017, there was this diverse group of MPs. Each one of them wanted to be sworn in their own
language. Wow.
And I thought that was important because as a nation, we don't all speak in the same language. And as a nation, we need to be comfortable with that diversity. But I also had the privilege of traveling the world in this job. And I'd seen how European nations, some of the wealthiest nations who accept diversity of languages and have policies such as a child has the right to be taught in the language of their choosing. Mm. You know? Mm. And so we need to be comfortable with
I love that. And that's what I sense, seeing you in the red tuinga and the fue, and you were saying to New Zealand, we are here, and I'm comfortable to be in this space in my attire. So mano.
And it's particularly important for your children, my nieces and nephews, you know, to see people like me, tall, dark, and handsome.
Yes.
bit of stomach muscle. comfortable in those spaces, because that's the future.
Looking back at your career, almost 16 years, what are you most proud of?
There's so many things. It's hard.
One thing.
I think the Dawn Raid stands out there. But, you know, the opportunity to be able to embed strategy for our Pacific languages and to encourage young people to be proud of who they are. The significant investments, which is significant, but more is required when you consider the inequities and the barriers that Pacific peoples face.
Any regrets? I know recently what come to light with what happened with the farewell for the CEO for the ministry, and that was under your watch as well as minister.
Yes, but it was operational, and I have to say it's regrettable, but all public servants do their best, and public servants, you know, are not infallible, they make mistakes. But that doesn't give the right to that ACT party to be joking around and saying they're going to bomb the Ministry of Pacific Peoples. That's just intolerable, disgusting. But the regret is there's so much more work that needs to be done.
Well, it's only weeks away, isn't it, from an election? Mm. And at the moment with the polls, it's not looking good for Labor. What do you think about that in terms of the results coming out?
I think what I'm most proud about is that the Prime Minister, the Honourable Chris Hipkins, is saying he believes we're going to win this. Now, governments, oppositions don't win elections. Government loses elections. So it's their election to lose. But look, the campaign hasn't even started yet.
You're very positive, I want to say. What do you want to say lastly to our community listeners?
I really want to say thank you. Whaftai, whakauelahi. Thank you very much for the support and the opportunity. and the love that you've given me to be able to fulfil the job. It's greater satisfaction when our community is saying to me, well done.
Whakawhitai Lassie, it's been wonderful to be speaking to you over the many years as well. Whakawhitai lava.
Thank you.